Pat, this first Bring It On question today is from Casey, who says, my ex-boyfriend and I used to be head over heels for each other, but he would often flip out on me and I wouldn't know why. After we decided on just being friends, it seems as if he would try to be spiteful and hurt my feelings. Now, every time we stop talking, we somehow reconnect. Sometimes I wonder if he keeps coming into my life as distraction or if he is the one for me. I'm tired of being confused about it, and I just have to pray. Please tell me what you think. I also feel abandoned by my father, so I don't want to end up looking for love in the wrong places.
I think you're answering your own question, Casey. This guy isn't the one. He's obviously unstable, yeah. And he's a little bit weird. So, you know, get away from that and find somebody who's reliable and steady. And I don't understand what's going on, but I can't advise you as to, you know, this, that, and the other. But he doesn't sound like he's, quote, the one. People look for a sign. I mean, forget it. I mean, don't forsake knowledge. God gave you a mind, he gave you an understanding, and you've got to, you know, you're talking about a life commitment, and this isn't the one. So tell him goodbye, it's been fun, we're through, and make it clear, you know, cut the cord.
Yes.
Okay.
This is a viewer who says, do you have to be water baptized to go to heaven? The church I'm in says if you're not baptized in water like Jesus, you will not go to heaven. I have prayed with Pat and I feel and believe I'm saved, but I don't want to go against my church.
I wish these churches somehow that the Lord himself would either teach them or shut them down, but it really gets upset. There's nothing in the Bible that says this. The Apostle Paul said, God sent me to preach the gospel, not to baptize. He said, oh, yeah, I baptized a couple here and there, but mainly I was here to preach. Mm-hmm. If baptism had been important to salvation, the Apostle Paul said, well, everywhere I went, I baptized people, but he didn't. What saves you is coming to Jesus and repenting of your sins and accepting him as Savior and being born again. But the baptism is a sign that the old life is gone. And the idea is that the Egyptians you see today, you'll not see again because they were swallowed up in the waters of the Red Sea. I mean, that's the whole idea. You're buried with him in baptism, raised in newness of life. But it isn't necessary to go to heaven. At least you ask me and I'm giving you my opinion. Okay.
This is Olivia who says, I'm 14 and I have always wanted to be touched by the Holy Spirit and fall under his power, but it never happens to me. My friend always gets slain in the Spirit and falls down, but I never do. Am I lacking faith?
Catherine Kuhlman was a dear friend of mine, and she would touch people and they'd just go out.
Mm-hmm.
So she prayed with me and, you know, and I just stood there. And he's kind of, what's wrong with me? I'm supposed to fall down. Mm-hmm. But, you know, falling down, jerking, barking, twitching, that isn't a sign of anything except resistance against God. But God will give you the power. Ask him. Seek him. Surrender to him. Receive. And then demonstrate. And you begin to worship him and tell him you love him. And out of your inmost being will flow rivers of living water. He wants you to be filled. And he wouldn't have given a command to be filled with the Spirit if he wouldn't want to make it available to you. All right, what's...
This is Haley who says, I'm almost 13 and was Jewish like my dad, but have now accepted Christ like my mom. My parents got divorced because of physical abuse to my mom and mental abuse to me and my sister. My dad wants me to have a bat mitzvah, but I don't want it. He has planned it for November and said his whole family is planning to come. I don't know how and when to tell my dad that I've become a Christian. I don't know what to do.
Look. The bar mitzvah, the bat mitzvah, is a time which you move from being to adulthood. It's kind of a rite of passage. It's a Jewish thing. Why not? I mean, it's do it for your family and get the family. I mean, together. I mean, it's a wonderful occasion, and you have singing and dancing and gifts and all the rest of it. What's wrong with that? I mean, that doesn't deny the Lord, and. Tell them at the appropriate time. I'm not sure I would tell them till after that ceremony is all over, because you're liable to cause a family confusion. But your father doesn't sound to be like a very nice man if he beat up on your mother. That's what you're saying.
And mentally.
That he was abusive to her.
Mm-hmm.
But anyhow, I wouldn't feel bad about, you know, having a ritual of that nature. I mean, it's a cultural thing, and you don't deny the Lord. Thanks. I'm so glad to have questions from 13, 14-year-olds.
Yes.
Glad you're watching.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
We love you.